spot trade versus forward trade. So on top of there being two different ways to express the exchange rate, like today's exchange rate between any two countries' currencies, there are also two different types of exchange rates. Not just how it's expressed, but different ways they can be used. So let's call that, so basically we can exchange currencies one into another using the exchange rate in, as part of two different types of trades. So there are two types of currency exchange transactions out there. The so-called spot trade and the forward trade. Spot trade is exactly what we have been talking about until now. So everything happens on the spot. That's where the name comes from. Immediately. So you walk into a bank, the bank immediately gives you some amount of euros in exchange for your dollars, right? So let's say today or year zero on our imaginary timeline is when the exchange of one currency for another takes place. What is then the forward trade? The forward trade has two important points of time. So there are two things that happen in this forward trade process. We can again think of today or year zero on a timeline and another point of time sometime in the future. So what happens today and what happens at that point of time in the future? What happens today is just locking in a specific exchange rate. It's not going to be used today. There is no transaction that will be taking place right now. The transaction will actually take place at that future time T. And the exchange rate that will be used at time T in the future is the one that was agreed upon today in year zero. So today we agree on the exchange rate. At that specific point of time in the future, we actually use it and exchange the currencies. So today we just agree to exchange one currency for another at a certain time in the future at a specific exchange rate. And at time T in the future, so it could be, let's say, in 6 months, right? What happens is the actual exchange of one currency for another using that exchange rate that was agreed upon in year zero. Going back to the spot trade, the exchange rate that's used in the spot trade is called the spot exchange rate. We denote it as capital S subscript zero. S stands for spot. Zero stands for year zero. So the exchange rate that's used today. How is it expressed? Is it how many dollars per, for example, yen, or how many yen per dollar? It's actually one US dollar equals this amount of, let's say, Japanese yen. Then the exchange rate that's locked in year zero to be used at time T in the future as part of the forward trade is called the forward exchange rate. The notation is capital F subscript lowercase t. So it's the exchange rate that's agreed upon today that will be used at time t in the future. A little detail about the spot trade. It's an agreement to trade currencies based on the exchange rate today, actually for settlement within 2 business days. So they kind of allow you to wait a couple of business days before you exchange your currency. So it's not really, it does not need to happen right away today. There could be a 2-day delay But within 2 days, you will be using the exchange rate, kind of going back to, you know, the first business day. So currencies are exchanged on the spot. I already mentioned that this is where the name spot trade is coming from. And that's the exchange rate we've been using so far in all our examples. So let's focus on the forward trade, which is something new. It's an agreement to exchange currency at some time in the future at the exchange rate agreed upon today. If you look again at that table with quotes for different countries' currencies, for the world's important currencies, such as, for example, for the Japanese yen, you will see a few additional rows. So for Japanese yen, there is a 1 month forward, a 3 month forward, and a 6 month forward. So for example, for the 1 month forward rate, in the second column, it says 108.03. So it means 108.03 yen equals $1. What does it mean? It means that you can enter this forward trade agreement today that will allow you to exchange yen into dollars or dollars into yen, whichever one you are planning to do, using, you know, this 1 month forward rate that you're locking in today. So you're locking it in today, you enter this 1 month forward trade agreement, and you will be using this exchange rate in 1 month. Whether you benefit from it or you lose from it, which depends on what the actual exchange rate will be in 1 month, that's a different question. Then the 3 month forward rate is 107.62 yen per dollar. 6 months forward rate is 106.96 yen per $1. Looking again at, you know, these exchange rates, as well as the spot exchange rate, which is 108.21 yen per $1. What can we say about the yen and the dollar? In particular, let's answer the following question. Is yen expected to get stronger or weaker over time, like over the next 6 months, against the dollar? And what about the dollar? Is it expected to get stronger or weaker against the yen over the next 6 months? The answer is, so look at the numbers. Spot, 1 month, 3 month, 6 months. We have fewer and fewer yen per dollar. So the dollar is expected to be able to buy you fewer and fewer yen. Is it good for people who hold dollars? No, it's bad. So the dollar is expected to get, we say, weaker over time. Or we can also say the dollar is expected to depreciate against the yen, lose value, right? And the yen is expected to instead get stronger or appreciate against the dollar. And again, you can see that about the yen from the numbers. So let's say, think about Japanese people who would be traveling to the US. Over the next number of months, they would be bringing fewer yen to their local bank to get each dollar. So that's good for the Japanese people, right? So the yen will get stronger or appreciate against the dollar. And that's because the forward rate expressed as yen per dollar is falling. The number is going down for a more distant future. Another term that means the same thing is premium versus discount. So you can also see that since yen is more expensive in the future than it is today, the yen is said to be selling at a premium relative to the dollar. And similarly, the dollar is said to be selling at a discount relative to yen.